Roller Bruschetta. Yo, what is up, AD team? Austin Dunham back again with another nutrition video. And in today's video, we're gonna talk about some of my favorite snack combinations that I've been eating over the course of years now in order to build muscle and just help overall with my progress. Because keep in mind, we know within diet we're gonna have certain meals throughout the day, which, you know, usually protein, carb, fat. But in between that, if you're anything like me, I like to eat snacks and not big meals throughout the day all the time. So these are some of my favorite. But before we get into that, be sure to like the video, subscribe, and follow me on Instagram at Austin_Dunham. If you wanna see some of my meals and snacks that I eat all the time, because I'm always posting on my story. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into it. All right, so when it comes to snacking and we're trying to build muscle, we gotta approach snacking a little bit different. And the way I do it is that I have rules for the snacks that I eat. The first one is that they must contain minimum 10 grams of protein in whatever snack that I am eating. And the reason is because protein is the building block and preserver of muscle. So if you're just eating straight refined carbs or just carbs, which is, you know, in most snack sources nowadays, such as chips, cookies, stuff like that, then you're not doing your body well. So we must have a protein minimum. And going back to the chips and cookies things, no refined sugar, no just straight carbs, none of that. No unhealthy typical snack food. We're not doing that. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into my first snack, and that is protein bars, which I have right here, protein chips, protein cookies. Any protein-based snack is pretty much my number one go-to. And the reason is because we easily hit that 10 gram minimum threshold, and most of these snacks are usually pretty solid in calories, satiating, filling, and it's gonna help actually attribute to your diet goals or whatever diet goal you're working towards. So my favorite are protein bars. And as you see right here, I have the My Protein bars, and My Protein is actually my supplement sponsor, in which you'll see me use a lot of their products on my Instagram and also showing these other snacks here soon. So right here, I have the birthday cake protein bar. It has 20 grams of protein, 3 grams total sugar, 260 calories, and 20 grams of carbs. So it's really, really not that bad. I love protein chips, protein bars, anything protein pretty much I can get my hands on. And like I said, this is My Protein. And these are actually a pretty good deal on their site. So you can actually use my code AustinNYP for all supplements, protein snacks for 45% off. So let's go ahead and move on to my next snack. All right, so my next snack is beef jerky. Now, this isn't something that I typically eat on a day-to-day type of thing. This is a snack that I use more for when I'm traveling. So if you're a traveler like me, stopping at gas stations, instead of getting chips or opting out for something unhealthy, what I tend to grab is beef jerky. Now, the reason why I don't eat this so often is because, one, I'm not gonna lie, beef jerky is a lot more expensive than all these other snacks that I'm about to show you. But the thing about beef jerky is that it's just pure meat. And since it is that, the calories are usually really, really good. For example, this one's 80 calories per 1 ounce, and each ounce provides 10 grams of protein and only 7 grams of carbs. Now, also about beef jerky, besides price, you gotta watch out for the additives. And if you're getting flavored beef jerky, then the sodium can be a lot higher than what you actually want it to be. So what I tend to do is get the standard original beef jerky. Don't go for teriyaki, don't go for all these special flavors, just get the original one. This one, sea salt, cracked and pepper, and it tends to have a little bit less sodium. But when you're traveling, this is definitely a go-to. All right, my next favorite one, and this is something that I tend to eat at night if I don't want a big meal or I don't feel like cooking, or sometimes even after a workout, is plain old-fashioned Greek yogurt. And I mix it in with some protein granola and some blueberries on top. You guys have probably seen this exact meal in some of my full day of eating videos. And the reason why you see it so often is because I genuinely love it. So Greek yogurt has a very, very good amount of protein and calories in it. I like to get the vanilla flavored Greek yogurt. This one's by Dannon Light and Fit. Been eating this for literally years. You go back to 2018, my 4-day of eating videos, you'll see the same exact Greek yogurt. And what I do is I sprinkle some protein granola, find any protein granola that you can find wherever you live. And then from there, I throw on some blueberries just for some added fruits. And bam, we have a good protein and carb filled snack. You don't gotta go crazy with the Greek yogurt, but it is really, really good. Like I said, I eat it before I go to bed. All right, my next favorite meal involves having a protein shake. So we have our protein bars, our protein chips, like the first snack, but a protein shake is actually more of a liquid snack you can have, and I like to pair it with a banana. This is probably one of your first snacks that you've ever had getting into the fitness community or bodybuilding or calisthenics, right? It's a typical snack that you see a lot of people eat, and to this day, it's one of my favorite ones, especially before I work out. The banana providing the carbs, potassium, energy, and the protein shake obviously providing the protein. So I'll either take one or two scoops, just kind of depends on how I'm feeling, but this is definitely a go-to. Now you see right here, once again, I have the MyProtein Impact Whey Isolate, which is a bit more quality protein. It has less carbs, it's more filtered, and it's also better on your digestive system if you do have problems digesting just normal whey protein. So once again, MyProtein, if you wanna check it out, AustinNYP, link will be down below. This is cookies and cream, my all-time favorite flavor. And now guys, for my last snack, and this is something that I haven't had in a long time. I feel like because I just forget that it exists, and that is protein ice cream, or low calorie, high protein ice cream. And this right here is the Halo Top one, but nowadays they make tons of protein, low calorie ice cream. But back in the day, 2018 timeframe, Halo Top was pretty much the top dog, and that's what I'm familiar to. So this one has 330 calories per container, which is crazy for ice cream. Most ice cream like this has over 1,000 calories per container, and it has 6 grams of protein per serving, and there's 3 servings within there. So almost 20 grams of protein for this whole entire thing, and it's ice cream, so that's honestly not that bad if you're looking for a sweet type of snack and you don't have any of these other options. So if you can, check out some protein ice cream. Like I said, I like Halo Top. You guys already know, it's cookies and cream again. So guys, those were my favorite snacks. Definitely implement some of these. Let me know some of your favorite combinations down below too. Subscribe, like the video, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next one. Peace.